October 10th, 3 days after Hamas's attack on Israel, and France's most watched news channel, BFM TV, is reporting an incendiary claim that among Hamas's victims were 40 infants.
Ils ont dénombré pas moins de 40 enfants qui ont été exécutés, éventrés. Parmi eux, des bébés.
The reporter making that claim, a claim which was soon disproven, was not one of BFM's own. He worked for I-24 News, an Israeli pro-Netanyahu channel that has the same owner as BFM, the French-Israeli billionaire Patrick Drahi. It was I-24 News that first reported the dead baby's claim.
Babies, their heads cut off, that's what they said.
Throughout this war, BFM has relied on I-24 News for much of its coverage, and it shows.
BFM TV has acted as a message relay medium for the Israeli military. A lot of space was given to a representative of the army, and that gave him a platform to spread propaganda.
L'hôpital Al-Shifa à Gaza est effectivement l'épicentre, le centre névralgique de l'activité du Hamas.
The fact that there is a through line from a propaganda channel like I-24 News to a French news channel, which is required to cover the news impartially, is an ethical problem. I don't even dare to imagine the reaction in France if we had a 24-hour outlet that broadcast content from a Russian channel. There's impunity when it comes to Israel.
Senior editorial staff at BFM have themselves taken issue with the channel's coverage, complaining to management about a lack of balance. Among their misgivings, the repeated interviews with a certain Julien Bahloul.
Julien Bahloul, vous êtes spécialiste de la société israélienne.
Described to viewers as a French-Israeli living in Tel Aviv, or a specialist in Israeli society, Bahloul is in fact a former spokesperson for the Israeli military, as well as a former journalist for I-24 News. BFM did not respond to our request for comment. However, some of those disgruntled journalists at the channel say its reporting has begun to improve. Coverage of the war by France's publicly funded news outlets and some of its newspapers has been more even-handed. But that still leaves plenty of others in an increasingly right-wing media landscape pushing some dubious, divisive narratives.
Moi, j'ai souvent eu l'impression...
I've often had the impression that the French media were telling us a story of civilization against barbarism.
Rien n'est plus monstrueux que de vouloir expliquer la barbarie.
Several commentators have told us we absolutely cannot compare a child killed by Hamas on October 7th and a baby killed by Israeli bombings in Gaza.
On ne peut pas comparer le fait d'avoir tué des enfants délibérément en attaquant, comme le fait le Hamas, et le fait de tuer des enfants involontairement en se défendant, comme le fait Israël.
La manière dont ils ont été tués, elle est différente et elle part de notre inhumanité ou de notre humanité.
What has greatly affected the media coverage is that there are very, very few Palestinian voices on TV panels. In most cases, there are none. We are invisible in the French media landscape. And so there are no voices to provide a counter-narrative, to correct lies, to correct an analysis that has dehumanized the Palestinian cause. Instead, for 2 or 3 weeks, we found ourselves in an endless debate about who considers Hamas as a terrorist group, who does not, who condemns it, who does not, without ever going into the real issues in any depth.
Nous sommes en France.
Since 2015 in France, we have been very sensitive to the risk of Islamist attacks. And what we saw on October 7th reminded us of the attacks we've had in France. So, it was the nature of October 7th that led to it being interpreted in that way. Even so, all opinions are represented in the French media as they are in most Western media and as I would hope at Al Jazeera as well.
The discourse in France over the war in Gaza is unique because of two factors. One historical, the other demographic. There was France's role in the World War II Holocaust, when the government installed by the Nazi occupation helped deport an estimated 75,000 Jews to the death camps. And modern-day France is home to Europe's largest populations of both Jews and Muslims. That demands a delicate approach on the part of the Macron government, which, for the most part, has been missing. Macron's interior minister, Gérald Darmanin, set the tone, quickly imposing a nationwide ban specifically on pro-Palestine protests, citing a risk of, quote, public order disturbances. France's top court later watered down that policy, which demonstrators had ignored anyway, risking arrest in their thousands. Darmanin's lopsided approach towards bigoted attacks has also riled people. Since early in the war, he has toured French TV studios, sharing government figures on the surge in anti-Semitic incidents. It took weeks of pressure from Muslim community leaders before Darmanin published the stats for Islamophobia, which has also spiked. Multiple right-wing voices in the media have been using the rise in anti-Semitism to delegitimize pro-Palestine protesters and to demonize Muslims.
Il faut le dire, pardon de l'exprimer de façon peut-être un peu brutale, il y a un antisémitisme couscous.
During the war, the issue of Islamophobia has somewhat disappeared from the coverage. What's more, there are Islamophobic media outlets in France. The most scandalous is CNews, owned by the billionaire Vincent Bolloré, who is a Catholic fundamentalist. He has become extremely powerful, and his news outlet spread Islamophobia.
On CNews, hosts like Pascal Praud or Sonia Mabrouk always emphasize that Muslims can't integrate, that they can't understand the values of the French Republic.
La haine du juif, la haine de l'Occident, et donc la haine de la France, c'est la guerre des civilisations, vraiment.
These media personalities read the Israel-Palestine conflict as the expression of an incompatibility between democracy and the Arab-Muslim world.
Arabo-musulman. Le traitement.
The coverage by these far-right news outlets has argued that if we are pro-Palestinian, we are necessarily anti-Semitic, and drawing links with theories about terrorism and Islamism. But we must not forget that many people from immigrant backgrounds in Europe come from the history of decolonization. We are facing one of the last colonial conflicts in the world, and so it's normal that people who come from these anti-colonial struggles rally around the Palestinian cause.
Rally à la cause palestinienne.